Let me record this session also. So today let us start with experiment number three. As I mentioned you before, in experiment number one and in experiment number two, it was based upon the basic laws for experiment number one and about the theorems for experiment number two. Okay, as I mentioned you, the recordings for experiment number one and experiment number two are available in the recording session. And if anyone was absent or if anyone wants to make a review, they can view the recordings. And apart from that, if they have any questions, you can ask me through the course message. So coming to the experiment number three, in experiment number three, we are going to study about AC. Basically, in experiment number one and experiment number two, we studied about AC. We studied about DC, basically. Okay, let me share you my screen. Okay, so in experiment number one and experiment number two, we studied about DC. Okay, yani both the laws and the theorems, it depends upon DC. Okay, that is direct current. The current was constant. And whereas in experiment number three, we are going to study about AC parameters. Okay, that is the measurement of AC parameters. In this experiment number three, there are three things we are going to, three sub parts, we are going to verify it practically, do it practically. The first part is how we are going to measure the AC voltage magnitude and how we are going to measure the frequency of the AC voltage, that is AC voltage frequency. Then we are going to study about the reactance and impedance of RC circuits, resistor and capacitive circuit. Okay, so what is the main important point here to remember? What is the main important point of difference is in experiment number three, it is about AC. In experiment number one and two, it is about DC. Okay, and also experiment number four and experiment number five is also going to be about AC. Okay, so let us start with the first part A, that is AC voltage magnitude. Okay, in this AC voltage magnitude, as you can see in your lab manual, there are three things. Okay, and this is the function generator, this is the multimeter, this is the CRO, oscilloscope, and all these three are instruments which will be available in the instruments tab in the Multisim software. And we have one ground. Okay, so let us open the Multisim. Okay, we require three things, right? One is the function generator, one multimeter, one CRO, and one ground. So let us check. This is multimeter, so click this. This is in the middle. Okay, and we require a function generator, which is the second one. So click this. This is the function generator. Okay, and we require an oscilloscope, CRO. So CRO oscilloscope is available here. So let me check. Yeah, this is two channel. So CRO is available here. So click and drop it here. Okay, so this is function generator, this is multimeter, this is CRO. We also require a ground. Okay, where is the ground available? From the place source. Okay, so you can click the place source as you have seen previously from the power sources and ground. Understand? Click OK. It will place here. Understand? Now complete the connection. How are the connections? You can see that the positive of the function generator is connected to the A, that is the channel A of CRO, and negative is connected to the ground. Okay, and the negative of channel A of CRO is also connected to the ground. Multimeter is connected between these two lines, that is the positive and the ground. Okay, so let us start with the connection. The function generator is connected with the A, channel A of CRO. Okay, and the negative is connected with the negative of the CRO. Okay, so now you can say that the ground The ground is connected to the negative. This is the negative. Yes. And the multimeter, this is connected between these two lines. This is for the positive line and negative line for the ground. Any questions in the connections? Did you got the connections? Understand the connections, how it is? Brother Hassan, Abdullah, Muhammad, Abdul Rahman, Maaz, any questions? Okay, let us proceed then. So, coming to the lab manual, okay, it is in here, Hassan, software part is all using multisim. Okay, inshallah, today we will complete experiment number 3 in software part. Okay, and in the next week, you will start experiment number 1 in hardware. Okay, so like I have produced and scheduled in the announcement, that is 3 weeks will be for the software part. Then the 3 weeks, then the from the next week starting, the 3 weeks you will study about the hardware part. Okay, and then you will come back to the simulation part, software part, using multisim for the 2 experiments. Then at the end, the remaining 2 experiments in hardware part. It is as per the schedule what we have planned, what is posted in the announcement. Okay, so let us continue with this. So coming back to the lab manual, here we have to set up the following parameters for function generator, for multimeter, for CRO. Okay, so how I am supposed to do it? This is the function generator. Double click the function generator. Function generator will open. This is function generator. Okay, double click the multimeter. Multimeter will open. Double click the oscilloscope. Oscilloscope will open. Okay, so we have selected all the 3 components. We have to make the parameters. How we are supposed to make the parameters? See here, in the function generator, we have to select sine. Frequency should be 500 Hertz. Amplitude should be 2 VP. Offset will be 0. Okay, so select sine. This is sine, triangle, square, right? So we are supposed to select sine. Frequency, we are supposed to give 500. From your keyboard, enter 500. Amplitude, we are supposed to use 2 volts peak to peak. Offset, we are supposed to use 0. Understand? Sine wave, 500 Hertz, 2 volts peak to peak, and 0 is the offset. This is for the function generator. Understand? Then coming back to the multimeter, we have to measure the voltage. So select volts and sine. So here, select volts. You can select ampere, that is to measure the current, voltage, resistance, and gain. So here we are going to measure the volt, and it is AC voltage. Not that if this is for the DC. Okay, this is for the AC. Understand? Then coming back to the CRO. CRO, in CRO you can see here, for time base, there are two things. Channel A, channel B, time base. Time base, what is the scale? It is 2 milliseconds per division. So here select for the time base, select it as 2 milliseconds per division. Okay, and for channel A, what is the scale? 2 volts per division. For channel A, the scale is 2 volts per division. For channel B, the scale is 5 volts. Channel B, the scale is 5 volts per division. Okay, and you can say you have to select here. This is edge, positive edge triggering, and this is A. Okay, so this is same positive edge and A, and here you have to use single. So here you have to use single. Okay, and here that's okay. Understand with this? Any questions? So when you proceed with this parameters, just simply click run. Okay, if you run, click run, it will simulate, the circuit will simulate. Okay, let me open it again. Okay, so let me select the reverse, it will be in white background. Okay, so you can see that when we give the frequency as 500 hertz, okay, the what is the voltage, measuring voltage, it is 2.82. this is the voltage from the multimeter. Okay, and from here we have to verify something. So you can see in the table, okay, there is a table, we have to keep changing the frequency, we have to keep changing the function generator peak voltage. First we have selected 2, then we have to make 4, 6, 8, 10, 12. So first for 2 we should write what is the multimeter value, what is the reading in multimeter. Okay, and these are for the CRO. For the CRO, how much is the division, how much is the height, then what is the peak to peak, and what is the RMS. Okay, so for this let me complete a table. Okay, as per this, this is for part A. Okay, this I will complete the results and I will upload this in the Blackboard, so which will help you to write the report also. Okay, so when the peak voltage is 2, okay, so let us go back to the multimeter. When the peak voltage is 2, here you can see the peak voltage is 2. So what is the multimeter value? 2.828. so in RMS what it is, 2.828, right? So this is for the multimeter. For voltage deflection, okay, so voltage deflection means it shall be with respect to this. You can see here it is V per division. Okay, so V per division for channel A, how much we have used? We have used 2. So you have to select here 2. Okay, then height is in centimeter. Okay, this one box in CRO, okay, one box in CRO is 1 centimeter. So here this you can see 1, 2, 3, 4. So I can say here it is 4 centimeter. Okay, now you have to multiply theta and h. So multiply 2 and 4, that is 8, right? Then using the calculator, this is VPP. VPP is how much? 8. So we have to, using the formula, converting the peak to peak voltage to the RMS voltage, we have to use this formula to convert this peak to peak voltage to RMS voltage. How to convert this peak to peak divided by 2? That is how much? 8 over 2 is 4. 4 multiply with 0.707. So let me use a calculator. So it is how much? 4 multiply with 0.707. It will result in 2.828. Okay, so at the end you can observe that when we are giving a particular voltage, peak voltage from function generator, okay, we are measuring the RMS voltage using multimeter, and we are measuring the peak to peak voltage using CRO. Okay, in this, here it is an important point to remember that always from multimeter you will get RMS voltage, root mean square voltage, and always from CRO you will get peak to peak voltage. If you want to verify it at the end, whatever you got the peak to peak voltage, is it correct or not, you are going to verify it using the formula, this one. So this peak to peak, if you convert it to RMS, this RMS what you get at the end should be equal to the RMS what you get in the multimeter. Then you can say that the peak to peak value what you have got is correct. The last step is only for the verification. So at the end you should compare this RMS and this RMS. Both should be near to each other. Any questions in these? Any questions till here? Yes or no? Did you understand? Okay, Mars understand. What about others? Hassan, Abdullah Ahmad, Abdullah Fawaz, Muhammad Abdul Rahman. Is it clear? Fahad Mehdi. Yes, I am going to complete table number one. I am asking you about the first value. Is it clear or not? Okay, so let us continue then. So coming back to the multisim. So next we have to make the peak-to-peak voltage, peak voltage in function generator to 4. Okay, so in the multisim, let us, you can stop this. Okay, increase the peak-to-peak voltage to 4. Now it is 4. Okay, and again run. If you again run it, you can see the multimeter reading is 5.657. So enter this value, 5.657. Okay. Next, in here, we have to note the deflection. So, but you can see there is a sine wave. We give the sine wave, but in the oscilloscope, in the CRO, you cannot see the sine wave completely. Okay. So always you should arrange the scale. Okay. From channel A, always you should arrange the scale such that you can view the full sine wave. So let me increase the scale. Previously it is 2. Now if I increase the scale to 5, now you can see the complete sine wave. Yes. And also, so now you can say that the scale is 5. So volts per division. Volts per division is 5. Okay. Previously it was 2. If you use 2, we cannot see the complete sine wave. To see the complete sine wave, we should change the scale. Now height in centimeter. To check the height in centimeter, we can move the wave. We can move up and down. Okay, if you move down, you can move up, you can move down using this Y positive division. Okay, so you should use such that it is starting from any one square. Okay, there shall be some starting point to start the measurement. So now if I keep it here, this value doesn't matter. It can be anything. It is only for the position. So from here, if I start, it is 1 box, 2 box, 3 box, and you can say 3.2, the grade. Yes. So if I put this, the height is 3.2 centimeter. Okay. Now multiply theta and h, that is 5, multiply with 3.2. Use the calculator. 5 multiply with 3.2. How much it is? 16. So put 16 here. Okay. Then again, VPP, we need to find VRMS. VPP over 2. So VPP over 2 means 16 divided by 2. How much you will get? 8. 8 multiply with 0.707. How much it is? 5.656. So you can say that this value is very much near to this value. So it is verified. Understand? So now let us go for same. We have to make it 6 again. So stop this. Increase the amplitude to 6. Okay. Again, run the simulation. Okay. What is the multimeter? 8.485. And here you can see the complete wave. Okay. So no need to change the scale. So move the position up or down such that you can measure it completely. So what is the multimeter? 8.485. So let me write it here. 8.485. Okay. Next, what is the volts per division? We have used 5. We have not changed it. What is the height in centimeter? Height in centimeter is, you can see, 1 centimeter, 2 centimeter, from here 3 centimeter, 4 centimeter, and a little less than 5. So I can say, you can say 4.8, for example, or 4.7 also is fine. So now multiply 5 with 4.8. So 5 multiply with 4.8, how much it is? 24. So here it is 24. Then 24 substitute in this formula, you will get this value. So let me write it for you. So it is how much? 12 into 0.707. 12 multiply with 0.707. How much it is? 8.484. So 8.484. So you can say it is near value. Understand? So similarly, you can say, similarly, you are supposed to do for 8, 10, and 12. Okay. So for 8, if I increase it, now I will show you only these values. So if I increase for 8, okay, and again run the simulation. So it is very much more. So you can increase the scale to 10, okay, and change the position up and down such that you can measure it. So now what is the multimeter? 11.313. So multimeter value is 11.313. Okay. And what is the deflection? Deflection, that is scale, we have used it as 10. So scale is 10. Okay. What is the height? Height is, you can say, 1 box, 2 box, 3 box, and 3.2, for example. So it is 3.2. And these two values, using calculator, you can find it. I'm not going to do it. You are supposed to do it. Okay. Next, change this to 10. Okay. Again, run the simulation. So you can see the complete wave. So move the position up for measurement. What is the multimeter? 14.142. So someone has pinged me. Let us check. Yes, I will send you not the Word file. I will send you the PDF file such that it will be helpful for you to write the report and submit me. Okay, coming back here. What is the multimeter? 14.142. 14.142. Okay, then what is the division? It is same 10. What we have used, it is scale is 10. And what is the height? 1, 2, 3, 4. So height is 4. The remaining you can do it. Okay, so next, for the function generator, increase it to 12. Okay, so let us stop the simulation. Increase it to 12. Okay, again run the simulation. What is the value for the multimeter? What is the value for the multimeter? 16.97. So write down here 16.97. Okay. Next, you can see the complete wave. Yes. So no need to change the scale. If you cannot see, increase the scale. Okay. So here you can see. So no need to change the scale. What is the scale? It is 10. Okay. Next, what is the height in centimeter? To measure the height in centimeter, change the position, move up or down such that you can measure it. So tell me in the chat box, write down what is the height. In the chat box, write down what is the height in centimeters. Anyway, what is the height in centimeters? No. So let me show you. See, this is 1, 2, 3, 4. It is till here it is 5. It is little less than 5. Okay. So 4.5 is exactly in the middle. If suppose it is here, then it is 4.5. Okay. So but it is a little less than here, so you can say it is 4.8 exactly. Yeah, so what we have used, so 4.8 like this. Understand table number one? Any question? Part A, did you understand how to measure the voltage in RMS and how to measure the voltage in function generator, that is CRO? How to measure the RMS voltage and how to measure the peak to peak voltage. Okay, so let us come back to the lab manual. This table I will put in the lectures tab. Okay, and coming to the part B, you can see the circuit diagram is same, right? Function generator, multimeter, CRO, and the ground. The circuit diagram is same, just the table differs, yani the parameters. These parameters will differ and the table is different. Okay, so if we set the parameters for the function generator, it is sine. This is 1 hertz, 1 kilohertz. You can say it is kilohertz. Amplitude is 2, offset is 0. Okay, so let us open. So here we don't require multimeter, so close the multimeter. Okay, so for the function generator, you can see it is sine. This is 1 kilo. So here, from here you can select, this is hertz, this is kilohertz. Okay, and this is peak to peak, it is given to select 2. Okay, so this is for the function generator. For the oscilloscope, for the CRO, how it is, time base is 2 millisecond. Okay, and channel A is 2, channel B we are not using, so channel A is 2, you can say. So let us do it. Time base is 2, channel A is also 2. Okay, is with us. So now, after setting the parameters, if you click run, okay, so here you can see that in this table we have to change the frequency. That is, first we have to make 500, then 1 kilo, 1.5 kilo, 2 kilo, 2.5 kilo. We need to check what is the time period, T2 minus T1. Okay, and after finding the time period, we will calculate what is the frequency. Okay, so first let us change the frequency as 500 itself. So let us make it 500, and this is hertz. Okay, so understand. So here we have to find T. How to find T? It is T2 minus T1. Okay, so here you can see that there is some points here. This is 2. You can see this is 2. This is 1. Right? So always put 2, like you can put, or let me make it big for you to understand. Okay, here you can see the blue color. Okay, this blue color is 2, it is written 2 over here. This red color, it is 1. Okay, so the time period you can measure between one cycle. Okay, there are 3 steps you can measure the time period. What are the 3 points? So you can measure, first you have to make it at the center. This is at the center. Okay, so you can measure the time period from here, from the starting of the wave T1, for example, from the starting of the wave to T2 is the ending. Using this T1, T2, you can use this. T2 is the ending of the wave. So this T2 minus T1 will give you the time period, 2.005 millisecond. Okay, this is one method. Okay, what is the another method you can use? You can select the top 2 crust. You can select the top 2 positions. This is the first top, and this is the blue color. T2 shall also be selected to the second top. Okay, so this will give you the same time period. T2 minus T1 will give you the same time period. This is second method. What is the third method? Third method is bottom. You can select the bottom 2 using the T1. For T1, you can select any 2, any bottom 2, corresponding bottom 2. So this is one. Similarly here, if you select this, the 2, these are the 2 bottoms, right? So these 2 bottoms will also give you the same value. Okay, so it depends on you which method you want to use to find the time period. You can use the starting of the wave till the ending of the wave, one cycle, starting of the cycle and ending of the cycle, or you can use the 2 tops, corresponding tops, or the two corresponding bottoms, that is the two corresponding crest and the two corresponding troughs. The name is crest and trough. Okay, so it depends on you, it will give you the same value. So here I can say that what is the time period? 2.005. So let me write the time period here, 2.005. This will be in millisecond anyhow. Okay, so now if I divide this, now what we have to do, 1 over 2.005 milliseconds I have to use. So using the calculator, if I say 1 divided by 2.005, okay, this is 0.498 milliseconds, okay. So if this milli is multiply with milli, any if milli comes up, it will be 1000. So what is the answer? 498.75. So 498.7, this is the frequency. So now you can compare the frequency in the last parameter and the frequency in the first parameter. Both the frequency should be near. This is to verify the frequency. Understand till here how to make the measurements? Any questions you can ask me. In the part A, we measure the voltage. In part B, we are measuring the time and frequency. That is the difference, main. Shall I go for the next reading to complete the table? Yes, brothers, any questions? Shall we proceed? Okay, so let us this. So next we have to make the frequency as 1 kilo. Okay, so change the frequency as 1 kilo. Change the frequency to 1 and select kilo from here. Okay, so run the simulation. Okay, this is the simulation. So again, we have to measure what is the time period. So select T1. You can use any method. Okay, so I will use this method, top 2 method. Okay, so this is 1. Okay, what about 2? T2, I have to select it on the top again, move it, click it such that it is on the top. So what is the time period? 990.566 micro. Okay, so here let me write, it was milli, so into millisecond. This is millisecond. Okay, so now it is 990.5 microsecond. Micro means you should know that it is 10⁻⁶. Okay, then substitute in the calculator, 1 over time, you will get what is the frequency, and it should be near to 1 kilo, yani 1000. Okay, next change the frequency of the function generator to 1.5 kilo. So change it to 1.5 kilo, stop and run the simulation. Okay, so again, so if you see that the wave is coinciding, so you can increase the time scale. Okay, so if the wave is small, you can, using the time base, in the time base you can decrease the time such that it is more expanded. Okay, so this is much more good. So again, T1, so let me use the two top two. This is one top, This is another dot. What is the frequency? What is the time period? 672.1 microsecond. So let me write it. 672.1 microsecond. Okay. Next, change the frequency to 2. Stop the simulation. Change the frequency to 2 kilohertz. Run the simulation again. Again, same procedure. Move T1. This is on the top. Move T2 on the another corresponding top to measure the time period. Okay, what is the time period? 495.2 microsecond. So it is 495.2 microsecond. Understand? Next, change the frequency to 2.5. So change the frequency to 2.5 kilo. Stop the simulation. Again run the simulation. If you see it is very much close, so again decrease the time base such that it is clear. Move T1. This is on the first top. Move T2, the second corresponding top. Okay, what is the time period? 406.8 microsecond. So it is 406.8 microsecond. Understand? So using the calculator, you can find the reciprocal of time, that is frequency. This is about part B. Any questions about part B? One over t. Using calculator. Vahadila, what is the rahum of t? You can calculate it.
Doctor.
Yes, brother.
What's the unit of 1/t?
It will be, if you calculate 1/t, you will get frequency. Okay. The frequency units will be same in hertz. Hertz will be the frequency. Units of frequency.
Okay.
Yeah. Any more questions? Shall we proceed to the last part? That is part C. Yes.
What's the unit of t?
Second. Time. The units of time is seconds.
Yes.
Okay. If suppose from the table, okay, here you get milli. So to this value, multiply with 10 power minus 3. If you got micro,
multiply
10 power minus 6. Yeah, multiply 10 power minus 6 like this.
What about mu?
Mu is 10 power minus 6. Micro.
Okay, thank you.
So let me write it here. For this is milli. Okay, so milli is represented by m, and it is nothing but 10 power minus 3. Okay, and you have about micro, it is represented by u, it is 10 power minus 6. These are the rules in general. Okay, rules. I will update this. Yeah, you should change from micro to seconds, not to milli. Okay, so if you change from microsecond to seconds, you have to multiply 10 power minus 6. Always you will change milli micro to seconds using the calculator, and substitute the values in the calculator, then solve, you will get some value near the first value. Okay, I think Abdullah Ahmad, let me show you one value. For example, this is 1 kilo. Okay, what you have got? 990.5 micro. Okay, we have to find 1/T. So let me write here 1 divided by 990.5. Okay, so if you put 990.5, what you will get? This value. Okay, so to this value, again, if you divide by 10 power, because this is micro, yes, so again you have to divide by 10 power minus 6. So divide by 10 power minus 6, or if you say multiply by 10 power 6, this is 10 power 6, right? Yeah, if you multiply by 10 power 6 also, it will be same. So what you are getting? 1009.5. so here you are getting 1009.5. so this is 1 kilo. 1 kilo means how much? It is 1000. So you can say that this value and this value are near, so it is that. Understand? If any questions, you can ask me. Yes, Abdullah Ahmed, did you got the point? Yes, okay. So let us proceed for the next part C. Okay, in part C, we are going to measure about resistance and capacitance. Okay, so there is a function generator and there is an oscilloscope. There is a resistor 470 ohm. There is a capacitor 0.22 microfarad. And we have a ground. Channel A of CRO is connected to the resistor. Channel B of CRO is connected to the capacitor. Okay, so let us first complete this circuit. Okay, so in here we don't require the multimeter, so delete the multimeter, so delete the connections also. Okay, so now you can see that function generator is the function generator is positive up, negative down. So I have placed something like positive up and negative down. Okay, and about the CRO, we have also selected such that A is on the top, channel A, channel B is at the bottom. So for you to verify, A is on the top, channel B is here. So now we need to select one resistor 470, one capacitor 0.22 microfarad. So let us select from the place basic. Okay, first we are going to select a resistor. So select a resistor. Okay, you can select any value. At the end, you can change the value also. All right, so this is the value of the resistor. So we need to flip this. Okay, what is the value of the resistor we need to select? It is, as per the table, it is, as per the circuit, it is 470 ohms. Okay, next we are supposed to select capacitor 0.22 micro. So same, place basic. Okay, select a capacitor, select any value, later on you can change it. So select this value. Now you can flip this. Okay, change the value. It is 0.22 microfarad. Understand? So all the values are there. Then complete the connection. Function generator positive is connected to the resistor. Negative is connected to the capacitor. So positive is connected to the resistor. Okay. Negative is connected to the capacitor. Okay, and these two resistor and capacitor are connected in series. Okay. Next, channel A is connected to the resistor, positive and negative. You can see in the table, channel A is connected to the resistor, channel B is connected to the capacitor. Okay, so for you to view it clearly, so channel A is connected to the resistor. Okay. Channel A is connected to the resistor. Channel B is connected to the capacitor, positive and negative. So for you to view it clearly, it's okay. So now the ground shall be connected to the negative part. Understand with the connections how it is? Any questions on the connections? Let me verify the connection. Yes, it is correct 100%. Okay, so open the function generator and open the oscilloscope. So now for the function generator, you can see as per the lab manual, select the following parameters for the function generator. Frequency should be 100 volts. Peak to peak, that is peak voltage, should be 5 volts. So let me change. Frequency should be 100 hertz. Should be hertz. And peak to peak is how much? It is 5. Peak to peak is 5. Okay. And then we need to vary the frequency of the function generator in steps and complete this table. Okay, and at each step using CRO, we are supposed to find what is the peak to peak value of resistor and what is the peak to peak value of capacitor. This reactance is needed to be calculated. Reactance of capacitor is needed to be calculated using this formula. XC is nothing but 1 by 2 pi FC. Then the total impedance we are supposed to calculate using impedance formula is ZR plus ZC. So what is the impedance of resistor? It is same R. What is the impedance of capacitor? It is minus J XC. So overall, this will be the formula for impedance. Okay. R, the value of R is 470. XC, what you get from here using this formula, substitute in the calculator, you will get it. Okay. So let us start with this. Okay. So let us run the simulation. You can see this when you run the simulation, you cannot see the complete wave for resistor as well as capacitor. So you remember we have selected channel A for resistor. So decrease this such that you can see, sorry, increase this. No, this you cannot see the complete wave, so decrease the time period. Increase the time period, okay? So increase the time period such that you can see the complete waves. Okay, so channel A, this is channel A. Using this position, if I move up, you can see, I mean to say that this is for the resistor. For channel B, if I move it down, you can say this is for the capacitor. Channel B is very much big, so increase this. So this is channel B. Okay, so select any starting point, and this is channel A. You can select any starting point. Channel A is also big, so let me increase this also. So let us change the position. Here it is okay. Okay, or suppose, okay, suppose I can change the color. Okay. If I change the color to blue, for example, okay, and if I run the simulation again, you can see that the blue color is for the resistor The red color is for the capacitor in order to differentiate how it is. Okay, so now what we are going to measure here, we are going to measure what is the voltage. Okay, so here we have to measure the peak to peak voltage. How to measure the peak to peak voltage? So for the resistor, okay, how much is the scale? It is 1. Okay, be careful, this is very important point, very important part. So to measure the resistor, that is the blue color, this is scale is 1 volts. Okay, what is the height for the resistor? It is, you can say, 1.4. so height multiply with scale, how much? 1.4 multiply with 1, it is 1. 1.4 multiply with 1, it is 1.4, right? Then for the capacitor, what is the scale? Scale, it is 10. What is the height? 2. 2 multiply with 10, it is how much? 20. Understand? Remaining part is using the calculator. If you have any question how to use the calculator, you can ask me through the course message. I will explain you. Okay? Understand how to measure the voltage of resistor, how to measure the voltage of capacitor. Okay? Then let me make it again for you. Stop the simulation, change the frequency to 300 hertz. Okay, again run the simulation. Okay, so this is very big. So this resistor, you can increase the scale such that you can measure, and the time also you can decrease it such that it is clearly measured. So start with some starting point. This also, it's okay. So now for the resistor, what is the deflection? It is 2, right? What is the scale? It is 2. What is the height? Height is also 2. So height multiply with the scale, 2 multiply with 2 will be how much? 4. So here you have to use 4. Then for the capacitor, what is the deflection? 10. What is the height? 2. So 2 multiply with 10, it is 20. Understand? Next, similarly for 500, stop the simulation, make the frequency as 500 hertz. Okay, then run the simulation. You can see the resistor is increasing. Yes, so for the resistor, you can increase the scale and change the position such that it is easy for you to measure. And for the capacitor, okay, so for the capacitor, coming to the resistor, you can see what the deflection, the scale is 5. Okay, and here what is the height? The height is, you can say, 1.4, for example. So 1.4 multiply with 5, you will get 7. Okay, next, for the capacitor, you can see it is a little less than 2. So you can say the height, the scale is 10, the height is 1.9, it is not complete 2. Okay, so 1.9 multiply with 10, it will be 90. Okay, so here from, you can here observe that as you increase the frequency, okay, as the frequency is increasing, the voltage of resistor will increase and the voltage of capacitor will decrease. You can observe this. So next, let us conclude for this. Stop the simulation, make it as 800. Then run the simulation. Okay, so move the position. And move the position for this one. So you can say that the scale is 5 for the resistor. And here the height is 1.8. Here you can say 1 is missing, 1 is missing on the top. So 1.8 multiply with 5. So it will be 9. Okay, and here for the capacitor, you can say also it is 1.8 multiply with 10. So here you can say it is 18. Understand? Then change the frequency to 1 kilo. So change the frequency to 1 and kilo. Okay, then stop and again run. So you can see for the resistor, let me make this also 10. Okay, for the resistor, I can say the scale is 10, height is 1.2, for example. So 1.2 multiply with 10, it is 12. About the capacitor, okay, it is 1.6, you can say 1.6 multiply with 10, it is 16. Okay, then increase the frequency to 2 kilo, increase the frequency to 2 kilo, stop and run again. So it is very much close, so increase the time, decrease the time. Okay, so now again same procedure. This is for the resistor position, for the capacitor position. Okay, so the resistor position scale is 10, 1.6 you can say, 1.6 multiply with 10, 1.6 multiply with 10, it will be 16. Then for the capacitor, it is 1.4 or 1.3 multiply with 10, it is 13. Okay, then change the frequency to 5 kilo, change the frequency to 5 kilo, again stop and run. Okay, then if you want to make it clear, increase the time, change the position. This is for the resistor. Okay, and for the capacitor, for example, here for the resistor, 10 multiply with, you can say it is 1.9, 1.9 multiply with 10, it is 19. Okay, for the capacitor, you can say how much it is. Here it is. So this is 0.5, 0.6, you can say 0.6 multiply with 10, it is 6. Then increase the frequency to 10 kilo. So increase the frequency to 10 kilo, again stop and run. Okay, so this is, capacitor is becoming very small, right? So change the time. So you can decrease the scale for the capacitor if you want to measure clearly. Okay, so for the resistor, you can say it is 2 multiplied with 10, it is 20. For the capacitor, you can see it is 1.5 multiply with 2, 1.5 multiply with 2, it will be 3. So the last parameter, increase the frequency to 20. Okay, then stop and run again. You can see the resistor has now become constant. 2 multiply with 10, it is 20. Okay, for the capacitor, you can see, you can change the position if you want. It is also same, 0.6 multiply with 2. So those are same. So it is 20 and 0.6 multiply with, or you can say, let me check. Yeah, it is 0.6. Okay, 0.6 or 0.7, you can say 0.7 multiply with 2, you will get 1.4 like this. So now as you increase the frequency, okay, the voltage of resistor will increase and the voltage of capacitor will decrease. Okay, so based upon the formula for the reactance and total impedance, you are supposed to use the formula from the lab manual. These are the two formulas, substitute in the calculator and complete the table. Understand, brothers? Any questions?